Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to our channel, Dayton Squad. So on today's video is the new arrival guide for passengers that are landing in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3. These are the passengers that are not flying with Philippine Airlines. Details coming right up. So I have uploaded an arrival guide for passengers flying with Philippine Airlines a few days ago. I also mentioned that I will try my best to find a step-by-step guide to those passengers that are not flying with Philippine Airlines. These passengers are actually landing in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3. And thankfully, with all the research, I found the Department of Foreign Affairs post on their Facebook page, a complete guide to all non-OFWs, returning overseas Filipinos, and foreign nationals, step-by-step guide when you travel to the Philippines this time. So let's get to it. So what to do when traveling to the Philippines? This video is for non-OFWs, returning overseas Filipinos, and foreign nationals that are eligible to enter the Philippines starting February 1 of 2021. So before your trip, number one, register the following ECIF from point of origin for a unique QR code to be presented to one-stop shop upon arrival in the Philippines. For Terminal 2 PAL passengers, you will have to register with Philippine Airlines. We have already posted a video on that on the step-by-step guide for arriving passengers flying with Philippine Airlines. I will leave the link in the description box just in case you guys missed it. For Terminal 1 and Terminal 3 foreign airlines, you will have to register with Padlub. I have a tutorial on how to register with Padlub. I will also leave the link in the description box for your reference, especially to those passengers who are not flying with Philippine Airlines or landing in Terminal 1 and in Terminal 3. Number two, pre-book at any Bureau of Quarantine accredited quarantine hotel for at least 7 days from your arrival date. And for non-OFWs and foreign nationals, prepare 4,000 pesos for RT-PCR testing and additional cash for transportation expenses. At the airport, number three, upon arrival at the airport, submit the accomplished health declaration form to the Bureau of Quarantine. Before anything else, make sure that you are allowed to travel to the Philippines by checking this link. I will also leave this link in the description box for your reference. Number four, proceed to the OSS or one-stop shop briefing area for a briefing by the Philippine Coast Guard on quarantine protocols and distribution of affidavit of undertaking. Number five, proceed to Department of Tourism desk for validation of quarantine hotel facility. So before you fly, it's really important that you have pre-booked your hotel already. That way, you won't be hassled anymore at the airport, and you are guaranteed with a hotel room when you arrive in Manila. Number six, proceed to private laboratory desk for processing of data and pay for RT-PCR testing to be conducted at your chosen quarantine hotel facility. So before, upon arrival, you will have to undergo the swab testing. But this time, that started February 1, you won't have any swab testing anymore at the airport, but you still have to go through the arrival protocol. You still have to pay for the swab test, which is 4,000 pesos. That will be conducted at your chosen quarantine hotel on the 6th day of stay in the Philippines. So please take note of that and please prepare your money to pay for your RT-PCR test at the airport. They will collect it at the airport when you are going through the arrival protocol in Manila. Number 7, proceed to Bureau of Immigration for clearance and passport check. Number 8, retrieve your luggage or luggages. Number 9, submit duly accomplished affidavit of undertaking to Philippine Coast Guard. Number 10, get airport taxi to your chosen quarantine facility or hotels and observe strict quarantine procedure. So for the information of everybody, you cannot hire a private vehicle. I know some passengers are just living within Manila, and I get this a lot in my channel that what if a relative of mine come pick me up at the airport and drop me off to the quarantine facility? No, that's not allowed. It's either the hotel that you are staying in will provide a shuttle for you to pick you up at the airport, or you can use the metered and coupon taxis at the airport that are there all the time, and they are actually authorized by the Philippine government to take passengers to the accredited hotel for quarantine. So please take note of that. While on quarantine, number 11, while on quarantine, plan, consider, and prepare the following. Number 1, airline or bus ticket. Number 2, letter of acceptance from your own local government unit. Number 3, travel pass from any PNP office at the point of departure. So this is what you need to do while you are waiting for your swab test result. That way you guys are ready already if your swab test result comes out negative. So if your final destination is to a province, you would have to book your flight for that. Then you will have to coordinate with your local government unit or LGU, because they also have different protocol for arriving, returning overseas Filipinos. I have experienced that when we went home to the Philippines last July, that I have to coordinate with our local government unit here in Gensan to know what are the requirements and what are the documents they need upon arrival at Gensan Airport. And they will also let you know what will happen once you arrive in your city on the protocols and the quarantine procedures that you have to go through when you arrive at your final destination. So most LGU really requires letter of acceptance. So it's really important that you contact them, because that's one of the documents that the airline will check before you guys are accepted for boarding. Also, the travel pass or travel authority, it says that you can get it from any PNP office. You can also get it at Terminal 2 in NAIA near entrance. Number 12, on day 6, take RT-PCR swab test at the quarantine facility by the assigned COVID-19 private laboratory. Continue observing strict quarantine protocols while waiting for test results. I also want to add that once you have checked in your quarantine hotel, you cannot go out anymore. So when you pre-book your hotel, make sure that the hotel that you are staying in will allow food delivery, or they can provide you food while you are staying there. Because like I mentioned, once you guys are checked in your hotel room, you cannot go out anymore. That's part of the protocol while you are waiting on day 6 to undergo the RT-PCR test, as well as waiting for your result of your swab testing. So please take note of that you will have to at least book 7 nights. Make sure that you have food for that 7-night stay in your chosen accredited hotel for quarantine. Number 13, upon receipt of negative RT-PCR result via email, wait for the Bureau of Quarantine Health Certificate indicating actual number of days on quarantine. And number 14, to check out, present yourself to the quarantine hotel facility in charge with documents mentioned in item 13. So on number 13, this is your Bureau of Quarantine Certificate. It says here, wait for your Bureau of Quarantine Health Certificate. Usually, you will have to request or email the Bureau of Quarantine Certificate. So for passengers landing in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3, it says here that you will have to wait for it, because it will be emailed to you once your RT-PCR swab test result came out negative. But just in case, you need to register and you need to submit an email, attach your negative swab test result. I will leave the contact information as well as the email of the Bureau of Quarantine just in case you need to request for it. Because with Philippine Airlines, they have to request for it. But for this procedure or this step, it was not mentioned, but I will go ahead and give you the contact information just in case you need to request for it. We also have a tutorial video on how to request for your Bureau of Quarantine certificate. I will also leave the link in the description box for your reference. Coordinating with LGU, number 15. Upon clearance, avail of authorized transportation to your final destination. Do not loiter around and expose yourself to possible source of transmission. Your delay in reporting to your LGU can be a ground of imposition of another 14 days quarantine. Always observe health protocols during your travel. That's why you guys are reminded while you are staying in the hotel, while waiting on day 6 for your swab test result, it is important that you have coordinated with your LGU already. That way, when you guys are clear and good to go and can check out at the hotel that you are staying in, you're ready, your documents are all ready, and you are good to go, and you can proceed to your final destination without worrying of being exposed of possible source of transmission. So please be careful. Even though you guys are negative, if your swab test result came out negative, you still have to be careful, especially if you are going out and headed to the airport. Number 16, upon arrival in your locality, report to your barangay officials for accounting and instructions. Your LGU has been informed earlier about your arrival through a DILG mechanism. So when you arrive at your final destination, coordinate at your barangay officials because you are probably recorded already that you are coming home when you requested for the letter of acceptance from your LGU, and you will have to continue the remaining days of your 14-day mandatory quarantine. Number 17, complete home quarantine at your barangay to complete the required 14 days quarantine or as your LGU instructs. Number 18, once released from quarantine by LGU, continue observing minimum health standards like wearing of face masks, maintaining physical distance, and washing of hands. So on the 14-day quarantine thing, I am not sure if some LGU will still impose the 14 days even if you have spent already 7 days in Manila. I will repeat this again and again and again. Please coordinate with your LGU because they are also following the protocols that Manila is imposing. So for sure, they have been coordinating that you have already spent 7 days in Manila and you just have to continue the remaining 7 days in your hometown when you arrive. You just need to coordinate with the barangay officials in your local government unit in your final destination. So please take note of that. So that is our step-by-step guide for passengers arriving or landing in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3. These are the passengers that are not flying with Philippine Airlines. Examples of these airlines that are landing on Terminal 1 and Terminal 3 are Delta Airlines, ANA Airlines, Japan Airlines, Asiana Airlines, EVA Airlines, and all that. As mentioned, these are the airlines that are landing in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3. To avoid confusion, these are the steps for passengers arriving in Terminal 1 and Terminal 3. Thank you so much guys for watching. This is our update for today. If you find this helpful, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family whom you know that can use this video as reference. If you are new to our channel, welcome. We do travel updates, and if you are not a subscriber yet, please consider subscribing and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you will be notified on updates like this. And to our subscribers and new subscribers, thank you so much for the continued support and trust to our channel, Dayton Squad. I hope to see you guys on our next travel update. Stay safe. Stay healthy and God bless everyone. Bye.